Java applet. So most of the Java's popularity among programming language has come because ang Java is capable siya sa web browsers. And yung support niya for small programs that run inside a web page can be utilized for creating interactive web designs. So diyan kilala ang ating Java. So si applet naman, si applet is a special type of small program that is designed to be embedded in the web page. So si Java applet is embed siya sa web page natin. Si Java is an application, si applet mamaya discuss natin. So web page to generate the dynamic content. So it runs inside the browser and works at client side. So applets are used to draw graphics on the screen. These small programs are written in the Java programming language. Applets are created from classes. However, applets do not have a main method, but instead have several methods to control particular aspects of applet execution. So, nakapag codings na po ba kayo sa Java or nakapag-try na po ba kayong mag-code sa Java? So familiar na po kayo sa body ng codings ng Java, ano po?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So ano po ba ang advantage ng applet? So it works at client side, so less response time. It is secured and it can be executed by browsers running under many platforms such as Linux, Windows, Mac OS, etc. So applicable si applet sa lahat ng programs and Windows. Okay, so how applet and applications are different? So let us know first about applications and applets. Java applications are standalone. So alam niyo na standalone ang Java application. So Java programs can be run through Java interpreter. Example, yung command lines natin. So everything we use during the basic Java programming courses are Java applications. So on the other hand, Java applications standalone Java programs that can be run through the example command line. On the other hand, Java applets are running inside a web browser. So si Java applet ay hindi siya standalone. Okay, kinakailangan niya ng web browser para mag-run siya. So reference to an applet is rooted in a web page using a special web page with an applet in it. So the browser downloads that applet from a web server and executes it on the local system. So kung nagtataka kayo, ano ba si applet? Si applet, makikita nyo siyang magpa-pop up kapag ka nagpo-codings kayo. Dito siya sa gilid ng screen. Para siyang meron kang mini screen, tapos makikita mo doon yung kino-codes mo. For example, nag-codes ka, naglagay ka ng button. So makikita mo agad si button doon sa applet. Okay? So kasi, 'di ba, pag nagja-Java programming tayo, makikita mo lang yung output kapag kaniran mo yung program, right? So sa
yes,
Java, sa Java applets, makikita mo yung codings mo and yung designs mo sa gilid. Okay? 'Yun yun si Java applet. So since these small programs run inside the Java browser, same capabilities ng browser such as sophisticated graphics, drawing, images, user interface elements, networking, and even handling are accessible for applets. So lahat ng programs inside sa Java browser is makikita mo siya kay applet. So yan yung difference ng Java application and ng Java applets. So, ito pa yung ibang difference nila. So, Java application is a program that runs by itself. Java applications are standalone. Java programs can be run by using the Java interpreter, for example, a command line. So a Java applet is not application, cannot run by itself, and it needs another program to run, usually a web browser program. So like Internet, Internet Explorer, or Firefox. So a reference on applet is embedded in a page. So na-discuss ko na yan kanina. Okay, so ang final significant difference between ang Java applets and applications probably is the biggest, the set of restrictions placed on how applets can operate in the name of security. So ano ba yung mga restrictions ng applets including, yung mga restrictions ng applets. So number one, applets can't read or write to the reader's file system, which means they cannot delete files or test to see what programs you have installed on the hard drive. Kasi nakadepende lang rin siya doon sa Java Java application mo. Kasi yun yung nagpaparan sa kanya. Kasi applet cannot run by itself. So applets can communicate with any network server other than one that had originally stored the applet. So to prevent the applet from attacking another system from the reader's system. So si applet, hindi siya makakakonect sa iba kasi kung saan mo lang siya tinawag na codes, doon lang siya magpa-appear. Okay, so applets cannot run any programs on the reader system. For Unix systems, this includes forking a process, and applets can't load programs native to the local platform, including shared libraries such as DLLs. So si applet is wala siyang local platform na kayang mag-share ng mga files such as wala siyang database kumbaga. Okay, so in order to create an applet, we need to create a subclass of the class applet in the Java applet package. So the applet class provide much of the behavior your applet needs to work inside the Java browser. So familiar na kayo sa mga classes ng Java, di ba? So dito sa code sa to, familiar na kayo. Ano? So ito yung mga naka-green na yan, ay naka-red na yan. Yan ay yung process ni codes kapag ka magtatawag ka ng applet. So the applet class can makes the applet work not only within the browser itself, but to access the capabilities of Java apps, Java's abstract windowing toolkit or AWT. Ayan, yung makikita nyo, AWT. So this provides the behavior of creating user interface or yung graphical user interface, GUI, and applications. So drawing to the screen, creating windows, menu bars, buttons, checkboxes, and other UI elements, and managing user inputs such as mouse clicks and key presses. So kung gusto niyo maglagay ng ganong mga process or designs sa program niyo, kailangan niyo munang i-import si AWT or si Java's Abstract Windowing Toolkit. So kailangan imported siya. So ito si Java Applet. Kailangan niyo ding i-import si Java Applet para ma-import siya doon sa code mo, makita mo siya. So unlike with other applications, no, Java calls the main. So alam niya lagi yun ang hindi nawawala sa code si main, tapos open and close parenthesis. Si main method, directly siya on your initial classes. So when your applet is loaded, Java creates an instance of that class. So, and all the systems based methods are sent in the instances. So, different applets on the same page or on the different pages that use the same class uses different instances. Para yung isa can behave differently from the other applets running on the same system. So, ito nga yung sample ng isang program. Kung mapapansin nyo, dalawang beses mong in-import si Java Applet. Ay, sorry. Dalawang beses. So, dito sa pag-ping ng welcome to Java, at ito, isa pa. Okay, so, different designs, pwede kang mag-input ng Java Applet. Okay. So, note, the public keyword Java requires your applet subclass to be declared public. So, kailangan naka-public si Java applet mo para your main applet, any helper classes you create can be public or private. Okay, next. Dito tayo sa life cycle ng Java applet. So, since the applet is running inside a web browser, so ang event na nandoon sa web browser should be considered. Sabihin, yung applets have many different activities also. So, it can correspond to the life cycle of the applet. So, ito yung example ng life cycle niya. So, initialize, started, painted, stopped, and destroyed. So, when it occurs, the browser or other Java-capable tool calls those specific methods. So, yan yung methods niya or yung life cycle ni applet. Ganyan siya gumagana. Ini-initialize niya, ini-initialize, and then it started, it painted, and it stopped, and it destroys. So, ano ba yan? Yan yung five most important methods ni applet's execution. So, for creating any applet, Java.applet class must be inherited. So, it provides four life cycle. So, initialization, the init method, public void init, ayan yung tinatawag nating initialization. Ito siya. Kita nyo yan. Public void init. Siya yung initialization. Ibig sabihin, nag-i-initialize na yung codes mo. So, si initialization happens when the applet is first loaded. So, kapag ka nag-load yung applet mo, ang tawag doon, nag-initialize na siya or initialization. So, initialization, nabubulol ako. Initialization can involve creating objects that you need. So, it includes setting up an initial state, loading even images or fonts, or setting parameters to figure the behavior of the initialization of your applet. So, you need to overwrite the init method. So, para mag-initialize siya, you need to override these codes. So, next, after the initialization, you will start, your codes will be start, the number two in the applet life cycle. So, how to start the applet starting? We have the code public void start. So, it invoke when applet is, it invoke after the init method or the browser has been maximized. So, yun, magagana siya kapag after ng initialization or kapag na-maximize mo na yung browser mo. Excuse me. So, ginagamit siya to start the applet. So, starting can also happen if the applet was stopped when reader follows a link to a different page. For example, kung lumipat ka ng ibang browsers, so mag-i-stop si applet. So, pagbalik mo doon, mag-start ulit siya dahil dito sa public void start mo. So, starting can occur numerous times during an applet's life cycle to provide startup behavior for your applet. So, you need to override these codes, public void start, to start your applet. So, stopping naman, public void stop, you need to override this public void stop to stop the applet. So, it is invoked when applet is or browser is minimized. Stopping and starting are closely connected. So stopping, on the other hand, when the reader or the page that contains a running applet, by overriding stop, you can suspend execution of the applet and then restart it if the applet is viewed again. Okay, naintindihan po ba ako?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so kala ko hindi naintindihan ako eh. So next is destroying. You need to override this code, public void destroy. Ang destroy naman is ginagamit to destroy the applet. So it is invoked only once lang. So destroying enables the applet to clean up after itself just before it or the browser exists. So for example, to kill any running threads or to release any other running objects, you need to provide cleanup behavior for your applet. Okay. So public void destroy. So next is painting. So public void, dito na mangyayari yung inyong mga graphics design, yung fonts, yung colors, dito na siya sa painting. So painting is how an applet actually draws something on the screen. So it can be a text, a line, a color, background image, or kung ano pang gusto nyong ilagay. So you can override these codes para makapag-design kayo doon sa applet. So if your applet needs to have an actual appearance on the screen, makikita mo yan siya by overriding these codes. Okay, next. So including an applet in a web page. So paano ba siya i-include sa web page natin? Paano ba natin siya mapaparan? So after creating class that contains applet, we will have to create a web page that will hold the applet using a special HTML tag. So ito yung HTML. Familiar na kayo dyan sa codes na yan, di ba? Kasi yan, napaka-basic sa HTML. So paano ba may embed si Java applet doon sa loob ng HTML mo? So by creating a Java applet tag. Applet tag is a special extension to HTML for including applets in the web page. So this is example. Shows a very special web page with an applet included. So HTML, the head, the body color is white. So center, applet, code is equals to my class, that class. So nakikita nyo, ito yung applet. Tinawag niya yung tag ng applet. Okay, ganun lang siya i-include sa web page or sa web browser natin after you design sa Java. So you need to close then the applet, the center, the body, and the HTML. Okay, so next. There are three things to note about the applet tag. So first is the code. The attribute indicates the name of the class that contains the sapplet, including the class extension. In this case, the class file must be in the same directory as the HTML. Ibig sabihin, yung codes na nilagay mo or yung class na nilagay mo, yung applet, doon din dapat yung directory na tatawagin mo. Ibig sabihin, same directory sila. So, width and height are required and are used to indicate the bounding box of the applet. That is how big a box to draw for the applet on the web page. So, you need to indicate kung ano yung size nung mag-pop up or mag-appear na applet doon sa screen mo. So the text between the applet and applet tags or yung may backslash applet is the close tags is displayed by browsers that do not understand the applet tag, which includes most browsers are not Java aware. So testing results. Now, with the class file and HTML file that refers to your applet, you should be able to load that HTML file in your Java capable browser. So the Java loads and parses your HTML file and then loads and executes your applets class. Okay, next is gumawa na ako sa Google Classroom nyo ng assessment. Google form siya. So ano naman yun siya? Multiple choice. So mamaya i-upload ko and then pwede nyo na pong sagutan yung ating assessment progress check. So we are done with our lesson 1. So any questions po sa ating lesson 1? You have any questions po para sa ating lesson 1? Any questions, violent reactions?
Wala po, ma'am.
Meron pa ba akong estudyante? Baka isa na lang estudyante ko dito ah.
Wala na po.
Wala pong questions? Naintindihan po ang ating lesson 1?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let us proceed sa lesson 2. Aba, magagaling na mga programmer naman pala itong aking mga estudyante ito. Okay, so proceed to lesson 2. The graphics, fonts, and colors. So, in lesson 2, we have 4 topics. The graphics, coordinate system, the drawing and filing shapes, the text and fonts, and the colors. So, pag-aaralan natin kung paano mag-design at kung paano mag-include ng mga yan. Okay. So, what are the learning outcomes? At the end of this lesson, students should be able to sketch simple graphical designs using coordinate system, apply Java graphics primitives including drawing and filing lines, rectangles, ovals, and arcs. So, yung mga artistics dyan, magagamit nyo to. So, compose simple drawings, pictures, and applet applying various shapes and colors, and discover how to modify fonts and to find out the metrics of a given font for better layout. So, sabi ko nga sa inyo nung ating computer programming 1, yung inaakala nyo na walang mathematics ang IT, nagkakamali po kayo. So, ang IT is mas pinahirap na mathematics. Okay, so let's proceed to topic 1. The graphics coordinate system. So let us start to learn how to draw the on the screen. So how to produce lines and shapes with the built-in graphics primitive, how to print text using fonts, how to modify color in your applets. So you can draw line shapes, characters, and images to the screen inside your applet with the Java's graphic capabilities, or kasi nga may GUI na yung ating Java ngayon. So most of the graphics operations in Java methods are defined in the graphics class. So ano nga ba yung graphics class? The graphic class is a part of the Java AWT package. So in your applet, does any painting as it usually will. Make sure you import that class at the beginning of your Java file. So, bago ka mag-design, make sure na naka-input si Java class. Okay, wait lang. Magcha-charge na ako na lowbat na yung cellphone. Ay, yung aking laptop. Saksak lang yung charger. Wait lang, guys. Okay, so continue. So to import the Java AWT graphics, you need to override this code. So public class, my class, extend, applet. So to import naman a whole package or in the end sentence with an asterisk sign, the following example will input all the classes in the Java AWT package. So import that Java AWT with the asterisk sign and then the semicolon and public class my class extend applet. Okay. So ganyan ang palaging nasa unahan ng inyong codes para ma-read niya, ma-read ni applet yung pinaglalagay ninyong codings doon. Kasi kung hindi niya yan ilagay, hindi niya ma-read kasi nandoon siya sa loob ng package yung mga magpaparan doon sa codes mo. Okay, so the graphic coordinate system, ito yung graphic coordinate. Siguro naman familiar kayo dito kasi high school, meron na tayong ganito, di ba? Yung graphic coordinate system natin, nasa ano pa? Ano bang tawag doon? Yung green na paper? Ano ba yun sa mathematics sa notebook natin? So, yun, doon siya. Oo, doon siya. So, gagamit kayo noon. Oh, gagamit kayo noon. Meron kayong activity na gagamit kayo ng ganun. Okay, so to draw an object on the screen, you call one of the drawing methods available in the graphics class. So lahat ng drawing methods have arguments representing endpoints. So lahat ng drawings merong endpoints, merong corners, and merong starting location of the object. So as the values in the applet's coordinate system, for example, a line starts at the points 10, 10, and ends at the point 20, 20. Okay, so Java coordinate system has the origin 0, 0. Yung origin niya is 0, 0 in the top left corner. So positive x values to the right, and all the pixels values are integers, and yung positive y values are down. All pixels values are integers, so there are no particular a partial or fraction pixel. So lahat ng value is integer, so yung mga hindi masyadong magaling sa fraction, so walang fractional dito sa Java. So Java's coordinate system is different from many painting and layout programs, so that have their x and y in the bottom left. So if you are not used to working with this upside down graphic system, it may take some picture to get familiar with it. So meron pa tayong marami tayong pwedeng gawin, hindi lang dito sa coordinate. So meron kayong task about dito, i-upload ko rin sa inyong Google Classroom about sa coordinate. So madali lang naman siya kasi since high school is alam nyo yung coordinate system na to. So let us proceed to the topic 2, the drawing and filing shapes. Okay, so drawing and filing lines. So the graphics class provide a set of simple built-in graphics primitives for drawing. So including dyan yung lines, rectangles, polygons, ovals, and arc. So to draw a line, to draw a straight line, use the draw line method. So the draw line takes 4 arguments. So kapag ka magdodraw kayo ng line, i-include nyo lang or i-override nyo yung codes na draw line method. So si draw line method ay merong 4 na arguments. Si x and y coordinates to the starting point, and si x and y coordinates at the ending point. So public void paint, syempre tatawagin niyo muna si paint para makapag-draw tayo. Ito kung paano siya mag-draw ng line. So x, ito si 25 is ang coordinate niya, si x1, 25 siya. So hanapin niya siya 25. Si y1 is 25. So dito siya sa 25. And si x2 is 75. Nakikita niyo ba yung mouse ko? Nakikita niyo po yung mouse ko?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So
yes,
si ma'am. x2, ito diba si x? Si
Apo.
X, gusto niyo pa bang pag-usapan si x? Ayan. So, ayan. Piling ko nag-gets niya naman siya. So, we have sa draw line, we have 2 x's. Oh, alam ko yung mga mararaming x's dyan. So, x is 25. x1 is 25. So dito siya, and si, ay sorry, x1, for example, dito si 25, and si x2 niya is 75, so dito siya, ganyan siya ka kalayo. Si y is, y1 is 25, so ganyan, ito, yan, 25, and 75. Ayan, 75. Okay, so nag-gets po, ganyan lang mag-draw ng line kay applet, kay Java. So, huwag niyo na kalimutan si draw line codes. So, g.drawLineCodes. Okay. So, in drawing and filing rectangles, sorry, hindi ko napalitan yung... So, the Java graphics primitives provide not just one, but three kinds of rectangles. So, meron tayong plain rectangles. Merong rounded rectangles, which are rectangles with rounded corners, and meron tayong three-dimensional rectangles, or which are drawn with a shaded border. So for each of these rectangles, you have two methods to choose from. Meron kayong dalawang methods na pwede niyong pagpilian. You have draw rect. Ito yung methods na magdo-draw kayo ng rectangle in outline form. So, rectangle lang siya in outline form. And yung fill rect, ito naman yung methods para ma-fill niya yung color ng rectangle mo. Kung gusto mong kulayan yung whole rectangle, so you need to override this fill rect method. Okay, to draw plain rectangle, use either the draw rectangle or the fill rectangle methods. So both take four arguments also. We have the x and y coordinates of the top left corner of the rectangle and the width and height of the rectangle to draw. So override the public void paint graphics. So this is how to draw the rectangle. So g.drawRect, ito yan yung first rectangle, itong walang color. So drawRect, 20, 20, yung ating x1 is 20, ang ating y1 is 20, ang ating x2 is 60, and ating x1 y2 is also 60. So ito siya yung left draw rect na codes. So kapag ka fill rect naman, ang magiging output niya is ito. Okay, so 120 yung kanyang x, kaya nagkalayo sila. So, ito yung spacing. Kaya 120 nandito siya. So, 20 and 60, 60. Okay, so, may nag-a-adjust with. Yes po.
Ma'am, excuse po. Ano pong record nyo na apps dyan, ma'am, na Windows para sa Java, ma'am? Kung sakali mag-practice ako, ma'am.
Ang gamit ko kasi is JC Creator. Ito po, ito yung kanyang logo, ito. Oo, yan. JC Creator. So, pwede kayo mag-stall ng ganyan sa kung meron kayong mga laptops. Pwede. Kasi, actually, hindi pa ako nakakakita ng mobile application para makagawa kayo sa inyong cellphone. So, yes, hindi pa kami nakakakita. So, kaya ang ginagamit namin is JC Creator talaga. So, try nyo itong mga...
Creator, ma'am.
JC Creator po.
Ah, sige po, ma'am.
Ayan. So, try nyo itong mga codings na to. So, basic codings lang naman siya. To draw, to fill. Ayan. Here's a paint method that draws two rounded rectangles, one as a routine outline with a rounded corner. So, sa rounded corner, 10 pixels square. The other filled with a rounded corner, 20 pixels square. So, ganyan lang din siya. X and Y, X and Y, X and Y. So, gets naman po, di ba? So, sa ano lang yan siya? Graphic coordinate system lang. X, X1, X2, Y1, Y2. X1, X2, Y1, Y2. So, ganyan lang siya. Pag-draw ng rectangle. So, ito naman, kapag mag-3D rectangle kayo. So, sa 3D rectangle, ba't din nag-church? Wait. So, kapag ka magko-color kayo, set color lang yung i-override yung code. Set color, color.yellow, gfill 3D rectangle. Ito yung dito sa hara, ito yon, ito yung codes na to. And then fill 3D rectangle is dito. Okay? So sa rounded rectangles, ay, bakit wala akong rounded rectangle dito? So kapag ka nag-draw kayo ng rounded rectangles, ito pala siya. Ito yung method, yung methods niya, draw rounded rectangle and fill round rectangle method. So kapag ka rounded, similar lang naman siya sa regular rectangles, except na ang rounded rectangles have two extra arguments for the width and height of the angle corners. So sa rounded rectangle, meron siyang extra arguments. Ito yung nasa dulo. 10-10, ibig sabihin niyan yung pagka-curve ng mga gilid niya. Kung gaano siya ka-curve. Okay? Gets po? Ayun na naman yung pinagkaiba ng codings nila. Nagsobra ng dalawang arguments para doon sa curving ng lines. Okay. So next we have a polygon. So polygons are shapes with an unlimited number of sides. So to draw a polygon, you need a set of X and Y coordinates again. And the drawing method then starts at 1. Draws a line to the second, then a line to the third, and so on. So as with rectangles, you can draw an outline or filled polygon. So ang method niya is, draw polygon and fill polygon also. You also have a choice of how you want to indicate the list of coordinates. So either as arrays of X and Y coordinates or as an instance of polygon class. So using the first methods, the draw polygon and fill polygon methods, take three arguments. So an array of integers representing X coordinates, an array of integers representing the Y coordinates, and an integer for the total number of points. So ito yung example codes ni polygon. So the X and Y array should of course have the same number of elements. So public point, public paint, graphics G, int access. Ito yung mga access niya. 39, 94, 97, 142, 53, 58, 26, and 39. So ito naman yung mga Y's niya, 33, 74, 36, 70, 108, 80, 106, and 33. So, int points is equals to x's.length, g draw polygons, x's, y's, and yung points. So, ganyan yung pag-codings ng ating polygons. So, madali lang naman siya, points lang naman. Kung hanggang saan yung sinet yung number, doon siya magpo-point. Okay? So, ganun lang siya. So, second way ng drawing ng polygon is ito. Yung nagkaiba niya lang is dito. Polygon poly is equals to new polygon, x's, y's, and points. So, fill polygon. So, dapat naka-fill polygon to. Naka-black or kung ano mang kulay siya. Kasi hindi ko siya nakulayan. So next is drawing an oval. So use ovals to draw ellipses or circles. Ovals are just like rectangles. So with overlaid rounded corners, in fact, you draw them using the same four arguments, the X and Y and the top corner. So the width and length of the oval. Note, because you're drawing an oval, the starting point is some distance to the left and up from the actual outline of the oval itself. Again, if you think of it as a rectangle, it is easier to place. So, as with the drawing, The method is draw oval method. So draws an outline of the oval, and the fill oval methods is the method to draw a filled oval. So public void paint. So ito yung sa draw oval 20, 20, and then 60, 60. Fill oval, ganun din. Excuse me. 120, 20, 100, and 60. So, same as lang siya sa rectangle. Ang pinagkakaiba niya lang is yung mga methods na ginagamit natin. Okay, sa pag-draw naman ng arc, of all the drawing operations, arcs are the most complex to construct. Kasi meron siyang mga meron na tong mga degrees. So an arc is part of an oval. In fact, the easiest way to think of an arc is a section of complete oval. So to draw an arc, you have to override the draw arc method. So it takes 6 arguments. So the width, the height, the angle, and the angle at which which to start the arc, and the degrees to draw it before stopping. So once again, there is a draw arc method to draw line, and there is a fill arc method to fill the arc. So tandaan niyo to, yung arguments ni draw arc. Yung starting niya, yung X and Y, yung pangalawa niya is yung width, yung pangatlo is height, pangapat yung angle ng arc, and yung 5 yung degree kung saan mag-stop. So first, we have the width. Ang width niya is 20-20. X and Y is 20-20. So 60-60 yung kanyang height, and 90 degrees yung start ng kanyang angle. Yung pag-arc niya is ito, nag-start pag 90 degrees, and mag-e-end siya sa 180 degrees. So ito, 90 and 180. So ganyan kalaki yung kanyang arc. Okay, nagets po? Pag fill arc naman, so naka-fill yan. Yung itong half, yan, naka-fill siya. Okay, so again, 20 yung X. 20 yung X and 20 yung Y. So 60 yung width. 60 yung width, and then 60 yung height niya din. And then yung starting, yung start niya ng pag-curve is sa 90 degree. And mag-e-end siya sa 180 degrees. So pag ganun siya. Ito yung magiging curve ng arc niya. Okay, so nag-gets po. So kung mag-set ka ng, mag-starting point ka ng angle sa 180 degrees and mag-end ka sa 270 degrees, so ang arc niya is pag ganun. Okay. So next is elliptical arc, same as sa arc ng pag-draw ng arc. With all the portions of the arc is arc in place, you can write the code here as the Java code for this arc. So both drawn and filled. So parehas lang din. So public draw arc. So 10 is the width. X and Y is 10 and 20. Width is 150 and height is 50. So yung arc niya will start at 25 degree and ends at 130 degrees. Okay, so ito yung arc niya. Starts at 25 and ends at 130 degrees. Negative 130 degrees. Kung positive kasi yan, pag ganun pala. Okay, so, okay po, gets po. Kapag ka-filled arc naman, so ganito yung magiging start niya. So 25 degrees kasi ito, mag-a-arc siya papuntang negative 130 degrees. Okay, so gets na po. Ito yung output niyan. Ito yung magiging output niya. Talaga. Yan. Ni draw art. Okay. So, gets po? Okay. Now, we will proceed to topic 3, the text and the fonts. So, sa text and fonts, the graphics class also enables you to print text on the screen in conjunction with the font class and sometimes the font metrics class. So, the font class represents a given font. So, ano ba yung mga font natin? Yung mga Times New Roman, mga ganyan. So, its name, style, and font metrics, nakakabulo lang, gives you information about the font. For example, the actual height or width of a given character. So that you can precisely lay out text in your applet. So in creating a font object, first, you need to create an instance for the font class. So for font objects represent an individual font. That is its name, style, bold, italic, and the font size. So font names are strings represent the family of the font. For example, Times New Roman, Korea, or Helvetica. So font styles are constants defined by the font class. So you can get them using class variables. For example, font that plain, font that bold, or font that italic. So, font styles are actually integer constants that can be added to create combined styles. For example, font that bold plus font that italic produces a font that is bold and italic. So, ang point, font size, ito yung size ng font as defined by the font itself. So, the point size may or may not be the height of the character. So, to create an individual font objects, use these three arguments to the font class, new constructors. Font F is equals to new font, open parenthesis, Times New Roman, font dot bold, and yung size niya is 24. So, pwede kayo diyang maglagay ng iba-ibang font. Okay, so ganyan lang maglagay ng font sa ating Java applet. So, drawing character and strings, you can draw on the screen using the methods draw string. First, you need to set the current font to your font object using the set font method. So, font is equals to new font times new Roman and font plain and 72. So, ito yung magiging output ng font mo na this is a big font. Ipiprint niya si this is a big font font with this methods. So ito yung magiging output niya. This is a big font times New Roman plain and 72 yung size. Okay, so this is to show an applet that draws several lines of a text in a different fonts. So first, you need to set the font class. So font F is equals to new font. So career, plain, bold, italic, bold, plus italic. So this is a plain font. So gets naman po siya. Di ba? Madali naman siyang intindihan. No need to explain further. So you need first to set the classes and then yung ipiprint or yung draw string niya doon sa applet natin. So, this is a plain font. Ito yung first. This is a plain, bold, italic, and bold plus italic. Okay. Questions po?
Wala po, ma'am.
Okay. So, finding out information about a font, we have this graph. So, you can find out some basic information about fonts and fonts objects by using this simple methods on graphics and font objects. So, sa get font method, ang object niya is graphics. Ang action niya is return the current font object as previously set by font. So, in get name, ito yung font. Ang action niya is returns the name of the font as string. So get size, ito yung size ng returns niya yung current size ng integer. Sa style, ito yung bold, italic, plain. So is plain if font returns niya yung true or false if the font style is plain. So is bold returns niya yung true or false if the font style is bold. So and so on and so forth. So kung malito kayo, tingin lang kayo sa graph na to kapag mag-codings kayo. Okay, so next we have the font metrics. So ang font metric class describes the information specific to a given font. So the leading between lines, the height and width of each character, and so on. To work with these sorts of values, you can create a font metrics object based on the current font by using the update method get font metrics. So sa get font metrics, font f is equal to new font times new Roman font dot bold 36 font metrics f metrics equals to. So ayan siya. So the table below shows some of the things you can find out using font metrics. So all these methods should be called on a font metrics object. So string width, given a string returns the full width of that string in pixels. Get accent, the accents on the font, that is the distance between the font's baseline and the top of the character. So ito yung pagitan ng, ito, halimbawa yung dito, yung pagitan niya dito, spacing. So get descent, returns the descent of the font, that is the distance between the font's baseline and the bottom of the character. So sa baba naman, kung ano yung spacing niya sa baba. So sa get leading naman, returns the leading of the font, that is the spacing between the descent of one line and the ascent of another line. So ito naman yung sa pagitan ng lines niya. Ng ascent and descent. So the ascent and descent, yung pagitan pa nun, ng spacing na yun. Ito yung get leading. So get height returns the total height of the font, which is the sum of the ascent, descent, and the leading value. Okay, so next, we have the colors. So ito yung paglagay ng anang kulay. So to draw an object in a particular color, you must create an instance of the color class. So to represent that color, the color class defines a set of standard objects. So stored in class variable that enable quickly to get colored object for some of the most popular colors. So for example, color that red will give you a color object representing red RGB values of 255, 0, and 0. So color white gives you this. So pwede naman kayong maglagay ng method lang na to, or kung gusto nyo yung RGB colors. So pwede rin. So you can create a color object for a combination of red, green, and blue as long as you have the values of the color you want. So create a new color object using this code. So sa internet, makikita niya rin yung mga codes ng iba't ibang colors. So, color is C is equal to new color, 140. So, anong color yan? Ano kaya magiging color nito? 140. Wala nakakaalam. So, alternatively, you can also create a color object using three floats from 0.0 to 1.0. Pwede ring float, pwedeng name, and pwedeng RGB value ang ating ilagay. Basta alam natin yung code or yung number ng RGB, pwede po. Okay, next is testing and setting the current color. So to draw an object or text using a colored object, you have to set the current color to be the color object, just as you have to set the current font to the font in which you want to draw. So use the method set color. So g.set color is equals to color.green. Or pwede rin gset.color yung value ng green. Yan, 0, 255, 0. So pwede rin ganyan. So the, sorry. So the set background method sets the background color of the applet, which is usually dark gray. So kapag ka naka-default yung applet, usually dark gray ang color niya. So kung gusto niya siyang palitan ng background color, you can set the you can use this method, set background color dot white. Okay, sa foreground naman, the set foreground method also takes a single color as an argument. So and affects everything that has been drawn on the applet. So regardless of the color in which it has been drawn. So set foreground color black. Sa baba yan, foreground. Okay, next. Here is an example of creating and setting colors in Java applet. So public void paint. So kung meron kayong mga laptops, pwede nyo siyang itry sa GC Creator, itong mga codings na to, para mas lalo po natin maintindihan. So, ang alam ko, mag-i-schedule kami, nag-aayos kami ng schedule para makapag-laboratory kayo sa school. Pupunta kayo sa school and then magla-laboratory kayo doon sa amin. Scheduled lang din po. And limited yung students. Okay, so intay na lang po kayo ng announcements para matry nyo tong mga codings na to. So, ito yung example ng setting a color. Color A is equals to new color, 51153255. Color B is equals to new color, ayan. So, set background, G set color, color, cyan, G fill oval, so, gumawa siya ng fill oval, 20-20-50-50, and G-set color, yung oval, na 70-70-50-50. So, ito yung oval number 1, number 2, and number 3. 1, 2, and 3. So, 20, 70, and 120. Okay, so, 50... 50, 70, and 120 yung Y. Okay? So, nagigets naman po. Alam ko nagigets nyo na to. Yung coordinates na yan, nagigets nyo na. So, sa pag-set ng color background, yung method lang na gsetColor, tapos yung color na gusto nyo. So, parang hindi mahirapan, yung name na lang ng color. Pero kung gusto nyo naman na merong combination ng color, basta alam yung codings. So, yun po yung ilagay dito. So, sa internet, marami naman yung codings ng colors natin. Okay, so, we are done with our lesson 2. So, any questions po? Questions?
Wala po, ma'am.
So, meron pa tayong dalawang lesson. Kaya pa ba? Or we will continue next meeting? Kaya pa ba ng ating internet connection, guys?
Next meeting na po, ma'am.
Next meeting na? Yung iba? Okay na next meeting? Kasi we have two lessons na. Sa bawat lessons, we have also 3 to 4 topics. Okay. Pero konti na lang naman siya. 10 slides na lang ako eh. Oh, okay na kayo? Next
ma'am, may tanong lang po ako, ma'am.
Yes po.
Ma'am, paano po pa nag-set background, ma'am? Paano kayo, ma'am?
Pag set background po, use the method set background. Set background and then yung color ng background.
Naka ano ba yan, ma'am? Sa unahan ba yan o sa gitna, ma'am, ilalagay, ma'am? Yung pinaka-code niya, ma'am?
Nasa loob po ng nasa gitna ito. 'Di ba nag public void paint graphics kayo, dapat nasa loob niyan yung mga designs niyo.
Ah, sige ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So, kung magde-design kayo, tatawagin niyo muna si class na graphics, yan, public void paint. Okay, so nasa taas niyan yung si init, si ito. Nasa oh wait lang, nasa na ba yung ito yan, yan siya. So, kailangan meron kayo maganto before kayo mag-codes. So, sa dito, after ng public void paint, pwede na kayong mag-design dito. Dito nyo na pwede nyo ilagay yung set background, set color, mag-draw kayo ng line, mag-draw kayo ng oval, so dyan. So, ito yung isang applet. Kung gusto nyo pa ng isang applet, so pwede mag-extend kayo ng isa pang applet. So, bale dalawang applet yung mag-a-appear. Okay, gets po? May questions
pa? Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so, may questions pa? Or continue ko na or next meeting na po? Kasi mag-enroll ako ng ano na. Mag-enroll ako ng master's ko last ano namin. So next meeting ko na lang po i-continue
next
yung ating. Oo, yung ating topic 3 siguro mga may klase ba kayo next week? May schedule na kayo ng class next week? Sa ibang
yes,
instructors ko. So anong araw yung wala kayong klase next week? Tuesday or Thursday or Friday kasi ang klase talaga natin ang klase ko talaga sa inyo is panggabi. Panggabi kasi talaga tayo sa klase eh. Ang 1F and 1G. So 5:30 to 8:30 talaga dapat ang klase natin sa schedule. Pero since hindi ako magka-klase ng ganon kasi baka yung iba lalabas pa para makahanap ng signal. So, delikado, delicate. So, hindi ako magka-klase ng gabi. So, ano po yung inyong preferred na araw? Kung yung wala kayong class and oral.
Ma'am, ma'am, yes, pwede bang regular na lang, ma'am?
Regular?
Kasi nakakalito kami. Kung baga kung
susundin natin kung yung schedule.
Yun ma'am, para mas maganda po ma'am, di na malito.
Okay, basta nyo kasi panggabi ako, panggabi nyo ako. 5:30 to 8:30 kasi ang klase nyo sa akin.
Okay lang naman ma'am.
Okay lang sa inyong gabi. Wala namang lalabas para pumunta ng computer shop or anything.
Okay lang ma'am.
Okay lang. So may mga sarili naman kayong gadgets na hawak ano. So sino po ba yung may mga laptops po sa atin? Kung may mga laptops po niyo na po, itry yung ating coding. So, okay. So, proceed po natin yung ating lesson 3. Lesson 3, next meeting. So, sundin na lang natin yung ating schedule. So, okay naman sa inyo pala na panggabi?
Ma'am, hindi pa ako makaka-join.
Hindi ka makaka-join pag panggabi. Bakit?
Kasi tuwing Friday po, ma'am, may simba po kami.
Ah, okay. So, yung may mga simba, ayoko makipagkompetensya sa Diyos. Okay. So, okay lang naman. So, recorded naman yung ating lesson. And post ko siya sa Google Classroom. And then, pwede nyo naman panoorin. Okay? So, ang dami kasi
nyo
naman yun. Sa 20, dalawang section. At tatlong sections kayo, si 1J ay pinasahan ko. So, sa tatlong sections, 20 lang kayong naka-attend ngayong araw. Okay, so next meeting, mag-announce na lang ako ulit kung kailan. And then, pasa ko na lang rin yung link. Okay, so before we end our lesson or our discussion, kindly open your cameras po for the documentation purposes. Open po ng camera ng mga magaganda at gwapo na yan. Open po, hindi mag-open, bagsak. Tiyari.
Yan.
Ang hindi mag-open, bagsak. Joke lang.
Ma'am, wala po ang camera, ma'am.
Magkikita-kita naman tayo pagka nagka-face-to-face tayo. Na-excite na ba kayo mag-laboratory? Okay, open. Sinasabi ko sa inyo. Meron ako
okay na, ma'am. Pakita naman ako, ma'am.
Okay na.
Salamat, ma'am.
Okay, so smile kayo. 1, 2, 3. Aha. Again. Again, 1, 2, 3. Tapawaki, sorry. Hindi siya sa si mama. Wait lang, save ko lang yung captured natin. Okay, next, last. Waki. Ano yung ang hindi mag-waki, ano? May manika ako dito. 1, 2, 3. Thank you and good afternoon po sa lahat. And see you po. See you next meeting. Pwede na po mag-leave. Sayang yung data. Bye!
Thank you po, ma'am.
Thank you po, ma'am.
Naiintindihan
yung aking lesson for today. Thank you.
Thank you po, ma'am. Salamat po.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
See you soon all.
Bye. Thank you po, ma'am.
Bye.